Hello and welcome, my name is John Dickinson, and I'm here to share with you exciting new usability and emission features of particle illusion included in Continuum's 2022.5 release. The main usability improvement is 3D widgets, which you can use to precisely transform your emitters directly on the stage. And while we still have the original behavior of clicking and dragging on the emitter to transform it, clicking and releasing will reveal the 3D widget. And you can see if I move my cursor over one of the axes, it turns yellow. So then if I click, in this case on the Y axis, I can drag up and down. Or on the X axis, I can drag left and right. If I click on the box, I can drag on both the X and the Y axis at the same time. Notice three new buttons up here at the top. We have Translate, which is selected now. We have Rotate and Scale. If I select Rotate, we now have a Rotate widget. And here I'll rotate this on the Z axis. Next to that is the Scale mode, and this will work with certain emitter shapes. It works with this box shape, so if I just scale this on the Y, on the X. And if I just change this to top view, it's a little easier to see the Z axis to scale it on Z. You'll also notice to the right of that is another new button. This is the world coordinates button, and this works with translate mode. So once again, I'll click to select, and notice how the axis is no longer rotated. If I deselect that, now we're back in object mode. And clicking and dragging, we'll move the emitter at that angle. Choosing world coordinates, I can leave the emitter rotated at this angle, but reposition it vertically or horizontally. So world coordinates becomes really handy when you've rotated your emitter. While we're in translate mode, notice that I can also select the corners of the box and I can scale it on that axis. So these new 3D widgets make working with emitters in particle illusion faster and more interactive. And something else that's made my workflow much faster is the new node functionality. Up until particle illusion 2022.5, nodes had been purely for navigation purposes, but new functionality includes double clicking a node to rename it. Double clicking on the icon disables the node and re-enables it, which I found extremely handy. The same for the particle node, and new particle node functionality includes double-clicking on the gradient, which opens up the color gradient editor, and also double-clicking on the particle shape to open up the particle shape editor. So just a few small but really useful additions to the way nodes work in Particle Illusion 2022.5. And there's also a range of other useful enhancements that make working in Particle Illusion 2022.5 more enjoyable. And I'll be showing those in more detail in the upcoming additions to the Getting Started with PI series. So definitely bookmark that page and keep an eye out for that. The big new emission feature in Particle Illusion 2022.5 is 3D model emission. In the emitter shape menu, you'll find a new 3D model option at the bottom. Models can be either Cinema 4D or .obj format. And once we've chosen the 3D model, we're presented with various emission and scale options. Plus there's a show wireframe option, which we can use together with the particles for some really creative looks. For example, here I've combined two emitters with different 3D models to create this glass and ice look. And another great new feature specifically for After Effects users is the new mask text emission option. In this example, I've got a simple point emitter, just emitting this puff of smoke. And in the Effect Control panel, change emitter type from defined by PI to mask text. And notice under the emission text options, I've chosen my continuum text as the emitter. So now the outline of that continuum text is acting as the emitter. And in 2022.5, these kinds of particle-based motion graphics effects are easier than ever to create. So, thanks for watching. To learn more and to download a free trial of Continuum, visit boriseffects.com.